The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
Biopsies done on representative treated tumors came back from the lab within 2 weeks of treatment and showing that those tumors no longer had melanoma.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Sona Nanotech CEO David Regan. David, very good to speak with you. You've just announced impressive first-in-human data for your targeted hyperthermia therapy, showing tumor elimination in most treated patients. Could you walk us through the results and what they mean for the company at this stage?
Sure, Steve. Thanks for having me on today. And yeah, we're extremely excited about these results. This really is a moment for us where we graduate from being a preclinical life sciences company to a clinical stage life sciences company. This study it's a very small 10-patient, what one calls an early feasibility study for a medical device. Ours is a two-device medical system. We shrink tumors. We cause, in so doing, an engagement in the immune system. And the results were quite profound in that we accepted 10 patients with late stage melanoma who were on and failing to respond to the best immunotherapies in the world. And yet we were able to get a response in 8 out of 10 of them, of which 6 were complete responses. In other words, biopsies done on representative treated tumors came back from the lab within 2 weeks of treatment and showing that those tumors no longer had melanoma.
So, I mean, David, as you say, the therapy appears to have worked in patients who are resistant to standard immunotherapy. How does Sona's THT differ from other cancer treatment approaches, and what potential does it have to address broader unmet medical needs?
Sure. Well, it's a good question because we get that a lot, and that this study was on melanoma. And the reason we started with melanoma is because it's accessible, right? We have nanoparticles that we insert in a tumor. We then shine a near-infrared laser on them that passes harmlessly through about 2.5 centimeters of healthy tissue, excites those nanorods. They convert the non-thermal light energy into heat. Heat kills cancer. What's different about ours, of course, is a couple things. Number one, we're doing that and we're limiting the temperature to 45 degrees, which is what's a hyperthermia level, so that it's selectively killing cancer cells, but not harming healthy cells that can withstand up to 52 degrees. What happens when you kill those cancer cells at that gentle heat level is there's a natural unraveling and apoptotic cell death that reveals new antigens that the body's immune system hasn't yet seen, causing the immune system to engage. So we're really helping to fire up the immune system to fight the cancer on its own. Now, immunotherapies, of course, have done that for 15 years, but they have serious limitations. Notably, their efficacy is in the number one drug in the world. The efficacy is limited to about 21% across various cancer types, 33% for melanoma. But we took 10 patients who were among that 67% for whom it doesn't work and tried this out. The other factor is those immunotherapies have significant toxicity issues. And of course, we have this gentle collateral damage-free therapy that has shown to have profound impact as indicated by the patients we treated.
David, you've mentioned plans to advance into a Canadian clinical trial with Health Canada approval pending. What are the goals of this next study and how will it build on the early feasibility studies we've just seen?
Right. Well, tremendous insights coming out of our early feasibility study, both in terms of the efficacy, and we're still analyzing the data. We've released the top line numbers here, but there's a database rich with data that we want to look into to further understand what was happening. Now, it's a 10-patient study, so it's not statistically significant, but we will be doing further, more detailed histological analysis of the tissues, and we hope to learn more about that. That will inform the hypotheses we use going into the next study and the protocol we draft for that next study. And that's something we hope to have kicked off by next spring.
So what are the next key milestones investors should be watching for, David?
So key milestones coming up. We'll have further data on the histological study. We'll also have further commentary on the direction. I mean, the great thing about these results is that they open so many doors for us. It's not just melanoma. We think we can have broad appeal for this therapy to a number of immune therapy resistant solid tumor types. So we're going to have our heads down for a little bit here as we plot the next steps. We want to do that carefully. We're going to be consulting with appropriate resources on the path. But in the very short term, we've made that application to Health Canada. We hope to engage with them shortly and learn a great deal from that. So there'll be lots coming for investors for us to update on.
David, I hope you'll keep us posted on your progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you very much, Steve. Appreciate it. Take care.
That's David Regan, the CEO of Sona Nanotech.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.